Brendan Rodgers has been in the presser today on the 29th of March 2024 as the football returns. It's felt like the longest international break ever, folks, but let's hear what he's got to say about himself. But most importantly, Calmac, the world's greatest player. We missed him so much during the international break. Celtic have missed him so much in the games that he missed before it. But he's no back. He's no safe, because he will miss the Livingston game as he's ruled out of Livingston clash. Of course, Celtic take on Livingston live on Sky Sports, 12 o'clock. Hopefully this one doesn't get called off due to rain, all weather, purpose, pitch, all that good stuff. But the 30-year-old was a huge miss for Scotland. Yeah, I'm just not fucking buying that. Sorry. But anyway, let's move on. Scotland were shite. And, you know, I'm not even bashing McGregor. It doesn't matter if he played, because we were shit, you know what I mean? So, come on. Let's not try and spin it on Cal McGregor, but Roger says, Calm has been out on the field, but we are not risking him in this game, but he should hopefully rejoin training next week. So, yeah, you know, very good chance he could take on Rangers. And bear in mind, right, plastic pitch, it's a game against Livy. You know, he shouldn't be getting fired straight back into this. Now, maybe from a Celtic fan perspective, which I'm not, you might want to see him on the bench and see him have like the last 10 minutes or something, try and get him a bit of game time, because he has been injured for a little while now. But at the end of the day, he shouldn't be starting this game. But the returns of Carr, Vickers and Rio Itati, and they both could be involved against Livingston on Sunday, and Scales and Naraki were also spotted in training. So for Celtic, they're beginning to get a bit of better injury news. It's been a very injury-hampered season for both Old Firm clubs. It has been, you know, both suffered. I don't think at the end of this season, either team can really sit and say, oh, well, because we had these injuries, that's why we didn't win the league. Both clubs have been hampered by injuries. It should never really be an excuse. And I never use injuries as an excuse, because at the end of the day, you assemble a squad. You just don't assemble an 11. But yeah, Cal McGregor missing against Livingston. I mean, it should make it a wee bit easier for Livingston, since the midfield maestro, you know, the guy that's better than Zidane and Patrick Vieira, all those iconic midfielders, he's not playing. So it'll definitely make it a wee bit easier there for Livy. But what did Brendan Rodgers speak about himself? Well, of course, he was asked about the punishment that was dished out by the Hampden Beaks, as they've been labelled here by the Daily Record. The Hampden Beaks, of course, you know, he got a wee suspension. He wouldn't be on the touchline. But then, hold on a minute, he's back in. We don't even know what's going on. So this is what he said. He says, we're obviously disappointed, but we respect the decision. My thanks go to the club for their unwavering support. We respect our punishment and we move on. He was then asked if he had any regrets over his comments, and he stood by his previous ones. He says, having previously declared that he did not regret his post-match slapdown, he said, no, I think there was just a misunderstanding of the interpretation, really. End of quote there for Rodgers. It's more just talking shite, isn't it? You know, I don't think it's a good precedent that you set. Because, like, let's be honest, I mean, he simply just got this ban, suspend it to the one game because he's taking on Rangers. You know, it's a Sky Sports game. It's the Old Firm. That's pretty much it. It says, in my time here, I've always talked about improving standards, whether that was with VAR or whether it was the pitches we play on. My whole drive is to improve the standards, and I just thought on that occasion it wasn't understood. So what do we think of Brendan Rodgers there, folks? Is he talking out his arse? Is he talking pretty good? Celtic fans, they lap it up, Rodgers, you know, before the international break. Oh, we won't be watching the game tomorrow. It's St. Paddy's Day. We're going to be. It's a celebration of Irish across the world. You know, the pandering that Brendan Rodgers has done since coming back to Celtic, man, is nothing short of laughable. You know, he's went balls deep, so to speak, balls deep with Celtic fans just to try and win them over. And you know, it is a bit cringe. I'm not saying like you can't do it, but you clearly see that he's doing it to win fans over that are still not won over, and there's just going to be a lot of Celtic fans that will not be won over by Brendan Rodgers. Doesn't matter what he says. You know, some Celtic fans, I'm sure Brendan Rodgers could join the IRA and it still wouldn't be good enough for Celtic fans. So anyway, folks,
joking aside, that's where we're going to leave this video. Cal McGregor still out, Brendan Rodgers still getting stuck in, but until then, peace.